Earth isn't normally an icy planet. For much of its 4.6 billion year history, it's been pretty much ice free, certainly without large scale glaciation. Two, my very short introduction is about the Quaternary Ice Age. And the Quaternary is the most recent period in Earth history, which covers the last 2.5 million years and includes the present day. Three, the term Ice Age, or in German, die Eiszeit, it was first coined in the 1830s by a botanist and sometime poet Carl Friedrich Schimper. Now, the Quaternary Ice Age is characterized by great shifts in global climate from cold glacial periods to warmer interglacial periods like the present day. Four, about 25,000 years ago, at a time we call the last glacial maximum, much of Canada and North America was covered by an enormous ice sheet called the Laurentide Ice Sheet. It was more than 3 kilometres thick at its greatest extent, and its southern margins extended down beyond New York and Boston and Chicago. Five, there have been about 50 glacial interglacial cycles during the course of the Quaternary Ice Age, and these involve profound changes in ecosystems with movements of plants and animals and also humans over the last 2.5 million years or so. And as a result of these major ecosystem reorganisations, there were many casualties, extinctions of the mammoth and the woolly rhinoceros, for example. Six, one of the reasons why the study of the Quaternary Ice Age is so exciting and so important is the fossil record is so rich and so well preserved. In the permafrost of Siberia, for example, we can retrieve full carcasses of mammoths and cave lions and woolly rhinos with good preservation of soft body parts such as brains and stomach contents. And we can even retrieve traces of ancient DNA. This is just not possible with the fossils from earlier geological periods. Seven, could we clone a mammoth? Well, strictly speaking, we can't bring back the mammoth because we would need a living cell to be able to clone it. However, we have reconstructed the genome of the woolly mammoth, so we know which genes are responsible for its long shaggy coat, for example, and its thick layers of fat. So it would be possible to genetically edit a modern Asian elephant to make it mammoth-like. That might sound rather appealing, quite exciting, but there are many powerful ethical reasons why we shouldn't do that. Eight, I must say something about extinction and about the history of our own species. So the Ice Age is also our story. Around about 50,000 years ago, we have genetic evidence for three distinct human species in Europe and Siberia. By the end of the last glacial period, we were down to just one. That was us, Homo sapiens, and we've become a globally distributed species across six continents. Nine, the Ice Age isn't just about ice. It's important to appreciate that we were dealing with global environmental changes. In the middle and the lower latitudes, for example, in tropical environments, many of the large deserts were much drier and much cooler during the glacial stages of the Quaternary. 10. Lastly, I must say something about just one of the very many reasons why the study of the Ice Age is so important. If we take long cores of ice from Antarctica and Greenland, we can measure the concentration of gases in the bubbles preserved in those ice cores. And that analysis tells us that the concentration of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is typically about 180 parts per million for a glacial period, for a cold period, whereas it's rather higher in an interglacial period like the present day, and it should be about 280 parts per million. The carbon dioxide content of the atmosphere today is more than 400 parts per million. It's now higher and rising more quickly than at any other time since we've had humans on the planet.